think it got water on
Hallo
it.
Hallo allemaal, het probleem wat hier opgelost wordt, hoor je zo direct meer over. Topnames iedere dinsdagavond vanuit Freedom Lab in Amsterdam. De gast is Laurie Goff. You're the founder and CEO of Outlander Materials Unplastic, the plastic-free wrapper. Well, it is a bit in the name, in the description, but what do you do?
What do I do? I have a startup that's meant to turn the wastewater from beer brewing and other industrial food side streams into a biotech conversion process where we create a raw product and then try and turn that raw product into unplastic, a functional, semi-transparent and totally plastic-free alternative for flexible single-use packaging foil.
So it looks like plastic to people, it feels like plastic, but it isn't plastic.
Yeah. Something like this.
Good. Yeah. This is one of the earlier forms. Yeah.
So show us what it looks like.
This looks like this. This was the first, the OG
Keep
unplastic.
Keep it a bit higher so you can see it on camera. Yeah.
This one.
So I just destroyed it. Almost. Yeah.
It's time. It's a year and a half old. Yeah. But it's quite transparent. It has a good air barrier, resistant to fats and oils. And is flexible.
Yeah.
So the idea is that it could be used to replace some of the single-use packaging we have for food and cosmetics to reduce plastic waste that's put into the environment.
Yeah. And this was 1.5 years ago. What you have gone through a lot of iterations on that?
Yeah, some developments. Yeah. These were medium stage, a couple with down here that are printed on. Show that we can also print with unplastic. So here, it's a bit smudged because I taped it onto the support structure incorrectly.
Yeah.
And then move towards the latest iteration of a flexible foil that can be produced potentially on the large scale. So with a professional manufacturing partner. And we've chosen to make it a bit more unplastic in appearance as well. Because some people feel that this looks too plastic-like and we want to avoid the confusion and it getting sent into plastic.
They don't believe it when you say, well, this is okay.
Yeah, because this really much feels and looks like plastic. I mean, you can find this these days around, I don't know, postcards or whatever, this kind of material. But you consciously decided to make it a bit different.
Yeah, to emphasize its beauty marks more or
Why
less.
Why did you start this and how long ago?
How long ago? I suppose the idea came about shortly after I came to the Netherlands. So my background is in biotechnology, and it was always meant to have something to do with turning waste into something with a higher function. I used to make biodiesel from used cooking oil when I was in the States.
Mm-hmm.
And when I came here, some friends gave me a beer brewing kit for my birthday.
So really?
Yeah.
one of those self-service
We've
had
them
here in our at this table.
In the office,
different initiatives of beer brewing, but then we started brewing beer, but there's a residue for that.
So of course you see this is where all the best ideas come from.
Yeah.
I looked into, well, the first beer I made was not terrible, which meant it was a massive success, and then I had to keep going down this path. And I considered to be an actual beer brewer, so I started speaking with brewers to see how can I be better, how can I step up my game. And we'd always come to the topic of there being a lot of wastewater involved in the brewing process. And it happened with every brewer I spoke to. And eventually I thought, okay, there's something there. And then I, very passively, just in a lot of free time when I'm sitting and thinking, eventually the idea of molding those two together to use biotech as a way of considering this wastewater a resource and how we can then convert it into something else. And then when I considered the raw product that would be developed, looking at the characteristics of it, I thought it would make an interesting alternative for plastics.
Yeah, but then having an idea to do something and then really decide to make a company of it or to make it your life, that's quite a step. How did that happen?
It happened because there was no other way forward.
Yeah.
I was working with the company, but our visions were not really aligned, and I really felt that this had a future. So the only option was to leave that company. And it felt a bit like
that was a traditional job in a big company. Yeah.
Which one? Job. Yeah.
No. Well. Oh, you don't want to say.
No need to say. But I learned a lot with them, and then it felt a bit like jumping off a cliff to do this because it was completely unknown. I have no experience otherwise in a startup. I didn't know all of the intricacies that would come with trying to turn beer waste into a completely different alternative for plastics. But I jumped, and then I landed at Blue City and the old Chapakana swimming pool in Rotterdam. And that slowly helped me to figure out what I'm doing, which steps to take.
Yeah, what is Blue City?
Blue City is it's the old Chapakana swimming pool that has since been converted into a circular economy business hub. Mm-hmm. So all startups and, well, bigger companies now too, that are related to the circular economy and sustainability can operate there. Yep. And it acts
You get free office space and...
It's not free, you still need to pay, okay. Of course.
Yeah.
There's also a lab in mm-hmm. the basement. And this was a very integral, like very crucial step for me, because there's a lot of lab work involved in the early stages.
Yeah.
And there also happens to be a brewery just a few okay. meters away. Serendipity.
So now I have this image of you in the basement with the residue from the beer brewer next door.
Yeah.
Spending nights and nights and nights to make something out of it.
Yeah, that's 100% accurate. Spend the days brewing with the guys. Very tough job. You have to taste a lot of beer.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the day, I could take all the wastewater and then just walk it over to the lab and start the experiments.
Yeah.
And then a year and a half ago, so August of 2019, I made that.
Yeah.
Just give us an idea. You tell this story of what you did, mm-hmm. but make it a little bigger. Are you on your own? Are you with 10? Are there 10 of you? What does the company look like?
The company is, at the moment, is mostly me.
Yeah.
It's a 95% a one-woman company.
Yeah.
I had some interns last year who were wonderful, but have since moved on to other projects. And in December, I was granted a City Lab grant from the City of Rotterdam. And now I have funding for the year, which means I can bring on more team members. So I'm expecting to grow to a team of 3.5 in the next half year.
Yeah, so there's a lot of different stuff to learn again now, because and you're the boss.
Yeah, a whole other set of entrepreneurial life.
Hey, and what sort of reactions do you get when you operate in the world you're operating in, because you had this idea, mm-hmm. you made it to the minimal viable products, so you've proven that you can do this, and then you start talking to people, look around. What does happen then?
Surprisingly, all the interactions are extremely positive, and from nearly every person that I've spoken to, even plastic companies, are really excited about it. So in the beginning, I thought that might be, they would see me as, well, not a really competitor, but a small irritation, but that hasn't happened, because it's not really about being anti-plastic. I do think plastics have a very important role in our society, for better and for worse. We couldn't live in the world that we do without them. And this is meant to be just an alternative in the way that we use and relate to our products.
Yeah. So, how do you look? What are the goals of your company?
The goals of the company in the short term, in the next 2 to 3 years, we want to create Unplastic on the large scale and to have this as an alternative foil for candies, dry goods, and as tamper seal for cosmetics and Lebensmittel home products.
Yeah.
I suppose. And shortly after that, the company is Outlander Materials, so we want to diversify the types of materials that we produce. So not only for alternatives for packaging, but to use this within other industries where it's also applicable.
And what makes you think that you can do that? Because we all know, I mean, inventing something is one thing, but then you know, if you start approaching the traditional industries, it's all about, you know, how easy is it to produce, the economics, is it more expensive? You know, we've had many startups here at the table, you know, they really had to fight the traditional industries to get somewhere. What makes you believe that you can do that?
Timing? Of all the things, it just seems that right now is a very sexy time for packaging. The entire world, everyone, not only people within an industry, but just the regular person walking on the street is now aware that single-use plastics are a problem.
Yeah.
How we use them, how we dispose of them, and sometimes the interactions they have with our products. And it's a thing that we cannot discard anymore. It's very active, it's in front of everyone's mind, and they want to change.
Mm-hmm.
And they can see that not only this, but other alternatives are out there, and they want that. And that's also true for larger companies. They want new alternatives and are looking for them.
Yes, they are, but then I presume you have contacts already with your...
A few, yeah.
They will also look at the economics, for example, or is it easy to produce it, is it scalable, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, it's not easy yet.
Yeah.
And at the moment it would be super expensive, but that is true for every technology.
Yeah.
It was the same for plastics as well.
True, but what needs to happen for you to make this a serious alternative for the current packaging of all those stuff?
It's part in the design. How we focus on this is not only that we're turning a simple waste into another product, but a systems design view. And that specifically we look at the waste from beer brewing because it's a resource that is already going
likely
to be
available.
Existing. It's everywhere. Everywhere in the world there's a brewery. If there's one thing we'll produce to the end, it's beer.
Yeah.
So this is here, and currently that waste is just, well, it's waste. It's discarded for the most part, unless you're a very big brewery that has their own treatment facility. So I'm actively designing a system that we can ideally place at the brewery so that their waste can flow into our system. We can produce on-site, minimizing transportation, supply chain issues, and ideally equipment. Then we produce it, harvest it, take it to a centralized location, and then produce it into foils or other materials in the future.
Yeah, but I don't want to sound cynical, but that's your dream.
Yeah,
but what do you need to fulfill that dream? I mean, we're talking about revolutionizing a complete industry.
What do I need on a very practical level? A process engineer.
Yeah, but then, I mean, once you have proven now that you can make this kind of material, but then to revolutionize a system, you know, you need... also, you know, the big companies on board, you need the willingness of people, you need a lot of money. I mean, how do you look at that, at the job ahead of you? I mean, this is not a simple startup.
It's not simple, it's not going to be an easy road, but it's possible.
Yeah.
And if I'm afraid that it's going to be hard, well, then I would have quit.
No, but we're often talking about how to innovate. I mean, and we often say, okay, you have to take things step by step, otherwise it doesn't work. You know, if you make problems too big, you can't solve them anymore. Is that how you look at it? You say, just take it step by step?
Both ways. So there's, of course, the end goal that we're aiming for, and also day by day I'm figuring out what I need to do.
Mm-hmm.
So first was to make this.
Yeah.
Then it was to get this, to see, okay, can it be produced in an industrial production system? This is enough proof that we can move forward. Now we have to see which of these larger companies has a... Well, for every item that you're going to package, it has a different set of specifications that it needs. So we need one, two, three foils to look for the next few months.
Yeah.
We'll match those specifications in the middle to see how we can develop so that it's useful for the customer as soon as possible.
Yeah.
After this stage, we... then we'll apply for all the certification testing that we need so that it's ready and available for the market. by the end of this year, we're planning to have 1,000 kilograms of this produced that's ready. And then after that, optimization to see how we can reduce the costs further. So there will be process modeling involved, I suppose.
Yeah.
Can anybody be against this?
I don't think so.
No, that's what I think as well. I mean, so but like you said before, you have the plastic, people that produce plastic, but if they can produce something else where they can wrap stuff, Lebensmittel in, they will be happy with it as well. Or do you meet people that say, no, plastic is really what we need to produce?
I've met one person.
Yeah?
In all the talks about it, one guy who was really resistant to it.
Who was he? Names. We'll chase him.
He might have been involved in sales. But
okay.
That's it. Even the plastic company, as I've seen, with the plastic bans coming along and then the issues with recycling, they're also they're going to just shift their focuses on alternative situations. And we need something different coming in.
But Roland asked, what do you need? But when you look into the future, is your company a company that will be acquired because you have a really good concept that maybe others are better in producing it worldwide or something? Or would you be happy with that as well?
I'm open to the idea. Ideally, we would be as independent as possible for as long as possible because there is a very clear vision and there's really no fear about it being difficult. So we will aim that way, but part of the business plan for the future is to share it as well, so that I can't operate at every brewery in the world, but a bunch of us together probably can.
So would we say selling the formula be a business model as well?
Yeah, we want to have our own production and sell foils and lead applications in new directions, but also sell this production possibility for others.
Yeah.
Being independent as long as possible is difficult for any startup because you just need money in this phase. You just tell us you got a grant from the city of Rotterdam?
Yeah, City Lab Notin.
Okay, how long will this last for you and what is the next step in terms of finances?
This grant in particular I need to use within 2020.
Yeah.
I've also just been awarded an MIT Samenwerkings subsidy.
Samenwerkings subsidy, cooperation.
Yes.
Cooperation subsidy. Yeah.
With RWO, and this will occur over 2 years.
Okay.
And in May, we are expecting to have a lot of results on production for both our bioconversion and the foil. Mm-hmm. And so here we'll make some very crucial decisions on which direction we go afterwards, which will also influence funding. I do keep open communication with investors because this is always a possibility. Potentially, I'll not find a 10 million euro grant. But otherwise, there are subsidies, there are grants, and there could be donations to otherwise move.
Yeah, it's really important for you to stay independent as long as you can, because the idea is the most important and the vision, right?
Yes. Yeah. So, a common advice I get is to aim only for niche and novelty products, but I don't feel that that's really what we need.
Why do you get that advice? What's the rationale behind it?
Because then I could sell it for more.
Okay.
And foil packaging is a numbers game.
Yeah.
Usually the lowest price wins.
Yeah.
So that's
not the direction you want to go in.
No, I
you want the masses to.
We need alternatives for foils, and some of us have to develop it so that it's there.
You said the name of the company is more than Unplastic.
Yeah.
So what if you look into the world around you, what other possibilities or what other problems do you see that need to be solved?
with just this this application, there's a big host of problems in the world to be solved.
Yeah, so this is enough, you mean, yeah. No, but what's the name of your company again?
Outlander Materials.
Yeah, but that's something different than only Outlander Materials is something different than only Unplastic.
Yeah.
So it gives me the idea that the bigger picture you have is about more than this. And I agree that you need the next 2 years to solve this problem. Mm-hmm. But is your vision bigger than?
Yeah, Unplastic is indeed, it's just the product line for the packaging foils.
Yeah.
And as a company, we want to be continuously in innovation and development. So I think, yeah, mostly if you want something to change in the world, you need weird and kind of crazy ideas to make that happen. And I'd like us to be one of those companies, just having a section that is meant to make mistakes, to try out new things and move forward, and then see how you can bring that to light. So we'd like to move into, well, applications that, yeah, that's quite a big list of them.
Were you surprised that with your ideas and the first proof of concepts, you were really, how do you call that in English? Omarmed? That people really cherished your ideas and you got so much recognition from different parties in the Netherlands. I mean, ASN Bank awarded you, you were a finalist of the World Award, finalist for the Sustainable Ideas Competition. The ING Bank Circular Enterprise Award nominee. I mean, were you surprised? I mean, because I would think there must be so many people worldwide trying to find alternatives for just plastic. I mean, it sounds so obvious.
Seems obvious. I was surprised, yeah.
Yeah.
I think there's only a few of us in the Netherlands. That's something that makes it unique. But also that it's not a plastic, it's not a bioplastic either. It is something different.
Yeah.
And it's meant to be used in a way that's different. It's all about circularity and being able to use the resources that we have here and are available and giving them a higher valued life. That's also solving a problem that we need.
Yeah. This is more of a circular idea than a plastic innovation idea, if I understand it right.
Yeah.
You are from America yourself.
Nebraska.
Nebraska? Is that America?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Yeah. But America is a big country.
Yeah. True. Is the Netherlands a good place to operate from?
Yeah, it's the perfect place.
Why?
I mean, Dutch people want to go to New York or Silicon Valley.
Yeah. The grass is always greener.
Yeah.
For me, this would never have happened if I hadn't come to the Netherlands. I probably would have lived just a regular life if I had stayed home. And then you had to make these very crucial and tough decisions in your life to move to another place, to start over. And if I hadn't done that, I wouldn't have been brewing beer in my kitchen. I wouldn't have run into Blue City. I wouldn't have started in that lab next to the brewery. And the Netherlands in particular has this, I don't know, internal personality of trait where you support these kinds of ideas. There's a lot of support from the gemeentes, the government, and everyday people who want these kinds of innovations. And if I had been back in Omaha, it wouldn't have been that way.
Yeah. No, the nice thing is that the whole thing is when you live somewhere, and of course it's the same when you live in New York or whatever it is, you take everything for granted. So you don't see the things that are special. So sometimes you need someone from abroad coming over to tell us.
Yeah. You need an outsider perspective.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's a really interesting venture you're building, and wish you all the luck in the world.
Yeah, I mean, it's great, and we'll support you by drinking beer.
We always ask one. Yeah, that's what we certainly do. We always ask you ask one question at the end of every interview. If we invite you again after a year, say in February or March 2021.
Mm-hmm.
What's the situation where you will be in by then?
Well, of course, we'll be having snacks that are all wrapped in unplastic,
yeah,
and drinking the beer that we made it from.
That's a good combination.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay, let's do that in a year's time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Jullie bedankt voor het kijken en we bedanken zoals altijd Bier & Co. voor de biertjes. PQR voor de hosting van de website. Jetstream voor de livestream en Freedom Lab voor de gastvrijheid. Kijk je live, blijf kijken, want zo direct nog een interview kijk je om die maand. Dan weet je dat je ons hele archief via fastmovingtargets.nl of YouTube kunt
terugzien.
En we terugzien.
Hebben nog een circulair interview. Het gaat weer over
duurzame
verpakkingsmaterialen.
Volgende, we zetten dus helemaal thema
als je
vast.
Dit interessant vindt, blijf kijken. Dag.